Entitled The Blue Room, Richard Rogers, 1926. As it happens, it was a commission. We did a wedding for somebody and they said, would we do this Blue Room thing? And they sent us a tape. And the tape was of a television program with Jeeves and Wooster in. I don't know if any of you saw it. Anyway, there's some of the background music to it. And when I heard it, I thought, gosh, that's a good band. That must be a 1920s band. In fact, it's a modern band. But it was beautifully written, and it sounded like an old-fashioned band. So we filched it, you know, from them. Yeah, that's what we did. Oh, it's suddenly got much more. Can you hear me now? Yes. Yeah.
It's a shame.
Sorry about that, man. What have we got here? Oh yes, this is to commemorate the fact. Actually, it's probably touched too much. That normally at this time of day, I'm asleep. So it's called Good Night, Sweetheart.
Thank you.
Built-in added attractions, and the first one of them is Dennis Armstrong who's going to come, and we're all going to sort of reorganise the stage to suit him. You know. The tune is called South, and it was recorded by Benny Moten's band. And prior to this band, there were two bands from which we sort of drew stuff. One was a band called Moten Swing, which astonishingly used to play tunes by Benny Moten. And this was one of them, and that's why it sort of relates to this. The other one was the Bourbon Street Braves, which played more New Orleans-y sort of stuff. Oh, here's Dennis now, Dennis Armstrong. Anyway, with Dennis, we're going to have a full brass section of two trumpets and a trombone, and we're going to do this tune called South.
Thank you.
Right, we'll try that. That's much better. We're going to do a Duke Ellington tune now. And this is called Misty Morning. This is Tiptoe Through the Tulips, Dubin and Burke. 20. I'll read it. 29. It's late as that. Right. Tiptoe Through the Tulips. Thank you. means a band, and I thought that was enough. But then, perhaps you'd like to know it, you know that. It's called Where He Leads Me, I Will Follow. Proceeds. Seem a bit ignominious after that. We're going to do another Duke Ellington tune called Stevedore Stop. Malcolm to sing. Have you heard Malcolm sing? Ah. Well, we'll see how it goes, yeah. We'll get Malcolm to sing. He's very good, yes. He's better than I am. I tell you, he's a better singer than I am. There's no doubt about it. And Steve, we're going to do a tune called When You're Smiling. And the arrangement we'll use will in part reflect a recording by Louis Armstrong here and there, and not in other places. Yes. We will see what happens.
With you.
Mark and Hurrell on the spinning. Jerome Kern, 1925. Who? Who? Short interval. We have here for your entertainment on trumpet Steve Graham. Trombone, Bob Kefford. Leads, Arthur Vincent. No, Mike Denham. Banjo and singing. Yeah. Not Hurrell. Brass bass sousaphone, Richard Willey. And drums, Mike Pike. Special guest, Dennis Armstrong, singing trumpet. And Penn Pengelly on the E flat middle clarinet. Thank you very much. We'll see you shortly.
Thank you.
Now that's has a tune by Duke Ellington called Blues with a Feeling. We're going to invite Dennis Armstrong to have a swig and join us for another occasion. We're going to do a Louis Russell tune, this. Yes, it's called Give Me Your Telephone Number.
Thank you.
is In the Garden.
Thank you.
We're going to do a tune that was recorded now by Paul Whiteman with an orchestra slightly larger than this. I think there were about 24 of them or so. I never got round to counting. I started counting. I got a copy of Rust at home and I started counting and I got confused and started again. And in the end I thought, well, nobody else is going to bother if I can't be bothered, so I'll say it's about 24 or so. It's a tune called Lonely Melody, and
do you do any bits on it?
Steve does some bits on this, which is nice. Was here somewhere. He spoke to me earlier. That's how I know. One knows these things, doesn't one? Yes. We're going to feature Richard Willey, our sousaphone player, on a tune, lovely tune by Gershwin, written in 1926, or at least published then, I don't know when he wrote it, and it's called Someone to Watch Over Me.
Thank you.
Does it occasionally, but you could hear it when he's blowing there. Yeah, we would do another tune before an interval. And this tune is a 1928 tune, Irving Berlin, called Putting on the Ritz. Thank you. Denham, Mark Howell, Richard Willey, Mike Pike, Dennis Armstrong, and Penn Pengelly. Another of the Clarence Williams tunes. This one we definitely did when we had the Bourbon Street Raiders running regularly. This is a tune called Black Snake Blues.
Thank you.
we've got Dennis with us, we're going to get him to do a tune which he discovered. And it's quite... Somebody reckoned it was quite difficult, so that's the pain for us, really, is he discovered it. But we're still going to do it all the same. It's quite pretty. It's called Didn't I Tell You That You'd Come Back? You know, it's a sort of one of these things, you shouldn't have gone away in the first place tunes. Yes, didn't I tell you that I'd come back to you?
I wouldn't have gave him that bloody tune.
Dennis Armstrong for joining us on the same afternoon. Dennis Armstrong! Recorded by Big Spider and the Rhythm Jugglers. And you may have heard me say, tell the story, but I'll tell it again for the benefit of the people who haven't heard it before. I analysed several versions of this tune before I did the arrangement, and Norman Field was very helpful in supplying alternative versions of this. The original one was done with Bix, the other ones were done with Red Nichols and people like that. And on the Bix version, there were three themes, two of which were very similar. On the subsequent arrangements, there were only two themes, and I wonder why it was, so I asked Norman, and he said, oh, they were all drunk. Which, I mean, would explain for getting an extra theme in, wouldn't it? We're going to do it anyway. We're going to do the three themes, the drunk theme as well as the sober theme, and it's a tune called Davenport Blues. If anyone were here, if you were here earlier when Malcolm was singing, and are still here. Anyway, he's going to sing another song. So, it's your own fault, really, you know, if you're still here. It's called Dinah. Could there be anyone finer? Thank you.
there anyone finer in State Carolina? If there is, you know her, show her to me, Lina. With Dixie eyes blazing, over us and gazing, just with a every night, why should I shake the pride? Because that dynamite plays your mind about me. Ocean liner, just with Carolina, just with Dali.
J.C. Higginbottom played and composed and recorded a tune called Higginbottom Blues. We're going to do that now.
Thank you.
Arthur Sims was the guy that recorded this. I don't know anything about him apart from his name. But Richard Willey, our sousaphone player, discovered the tune and thought it was rather attractive. So we're doing it because we thought you might find it attractive too. It's called As Long As I Have You. This next number is Fletcher Anderson, or is based on a Fletcher Anderson recording. It's a tune called D Natural Blues. Astonishingly, it's in the key of D Natural.
Thank you.
but we still seem to have caught up. I better tell you who's in the band. We have on lead trumpet, Steve Graham. Yeah. On trombone, we have Bob Kefford. On the reeds, Arthur Vincent. On the piano is Mike Denham. The banjo and the singing is Malcolm Hurrell. On the sousaphone is Richard Willey. On the drums is Mike Pike. With us today we've had special guest Penn Pengelly. And Dennis Armstrong. Graham, who was the musical director of the London Hippodrome and was Gertrude Lawrence's musical director, to wrote this next tune. I'm getting that right because the person who told me it might be in the room. He would be very cross if I omitted to tell you. But it's a good tune. It's called Limehouse Blues. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Have a jolly good rest of the festival. You know, go on. Have a nice time. Cheers. Thank you very much.